everyone. My name is Janessa, and I'm the Director of Student Ministries at Plattwoods UMC. We're starting a new series today called Stretch. It's all about how we can stretch our faith and grow closer to God. So before we get started, turn to someone sitting next to you or as a small group or someone if you're watching this video with someone and answer this question together. On a scale of telephone pole, so like very rigid, to silly putty, how flexible are you? Some people are just naturally more flexible than others. Like, I can touch my toes, but I can't put my foot behind my head. And while I might never be able to do that, I know if I stretch on a regular basis, I can get more flexible. And stretching is awesome for your body. And even like it might hurt when you first start doing it, and it can be difficult when you first start stretching. If you commit to stretching regularly, it gets easier and you can be more flexible, and it can improve your health. Just like your body, if you want your faith to be strong and growing and capable of carrying you through difficult situations, you're going to need to stretch. If your faith were a muscle and were like had flexibility, how flexible would it be? Could you touch your knees, your shins, or your toes? Are you just like not even sure you have faith to stretch right now? No matter how far or not so far your faith can stretch right now, if you want your faith to grow, you're going to need to stretch it. This month, we're going to challenge ourselves to stretch our faith together. It might be fun and it might be difficult, but no matter what, we think it's going to be so worthwhile. Because here's the key, whether it's your muscles or your faith, stretching only works if you commit to actually doing it. I've learned that no matter what goal I'm trying to achieve, commitment is an essential part of the process. So like during quarantine, I've picked up a lot of hobbies because I'm an Enneagram 7. We basically have a million hobbies. So far I've done cross stitching. I've done a lot of Animal Crossing. I've done some crocheting. I've done puzzles. And now I just want to learn to knit. So I think I just admitted to being like a 27-year-old grandma. That's okay. Anyway, so the first month of quarantine, I was all about cross stitching. Like, I was super excited. I told my fiance that I was like, this is the perfect hobby for me. I can be creative as creative as I want. Each pattern is different, so it like helps keep that like I want to do a bunch of different things going. And then it helps me calm my mind, which is what you want in a hobby. But then I did like 2 cross stitch patterns, and none of them were bad. None of them were great. And then I just got kind of bored because I was like, I want to do something different. So I still have to like look up how to do cross stitching like certain stitches because I'm not close to mastering the skill. But then I was just like, I just want to play Animal Crossing, or I just want to do puzzles, or I just want to crochet scarves. And now I'm just like, I just want to learn how to knit. So many of us treat our faith the exact same way. We want results, but we don't really want to commit to learning to do the work that would stretch our faith. We get excited about following Jesus, but then after a few days or weeks or months, our commitment kind of decreases along with our excitement. In scripture, we hear a lot about how we can stretch our faith, our own faith, from the stories and the words of the Jesus followers who have gone before us. So today we're going to look at the story of when Jesus calls his disciples, but there's all these other stories too, like the story of Mary Magdalene or any of the stories about Paul. So anyway, we're going to look at Matthew 4, 18 through 20. As Jesus was walking beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon called Peter and his brother Andrew. They were casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. Come, follow me, Jesus said, and I will send you out to fish for people. And at once they left their nets and followed him. So Peter and Andrew had pretty normal lives that were, you know, like had a secure career as a fisherman, but then everything changed when they committed to following Jesus. Jesus is calling them from their old lives by saying, follow me, I'll make you fishers of men. They had no idea, but these two brothers were about to go on a crazy journey about following Jesus. Peter and Andrew had left everything they had ever known to follow Jesus. In fact, the Bible says it was immediate, or at once they dropped their nets, which like, talk about a commitment. But this was one of the first of many moments Peter and Andrew would have that would stretch their faith. They made this commitment and then they spent the rest of their lives living it out. There's no bigger way, I feel like, to stretch your faith than stepping out of your comfort zone. And in the moment, it can be really scary, but the reward is so worth it. I mean, look at Peter and Andrew. Years later, Peter and Andrew have become apostles of the early church, and they were sharing the good news of Jesus everywhere, even though there was dangerous circumstances. And then Peter would become one of the most important figures in the entire history of the church. The work they did after leaving their nets was huge, but without them, we might not even have the church today, and it all started with this one commitment. God has been helping people like you and me stretch our faith. So for the next few weeks, we're going to talk about some ways we can do that, but for now, it all starts here. You can stretch your faith with a commitment. Because here's the thing, just like doing one sit-up is not going to get you a six-pack, reading the Bible or praying once isn't going to get you far in your relationship with Jesus. Following Jesus and growing closer to Him and stretching our faith is a daily thing. Think about where you want to be in your faith in a year from now. Or so maybe for you in a year from now, you want to have a really awesome prayer life. Or maybe for you, you just like want to be in the habit of reading your Bible daily. Or maybe you're just like kind of starting to test the waters of faith. You don't even know if you have a faith that you can stretch. So for you in a year from now, you just want to know what it means to follow Jesus. So in our small groups today, you're going to get one of these stretch commitment cards. And if you're watching this online, don't worry, it'll be like all over our social medias. So in this series, each week, I'm going to ask you to make some commitments because that's how we know stretching works. So this week, what is one stretch that you can commit to doing? So on the card, it has all of these options. So you have first, show up. To start, maybe you just need to commit to coming next week or the next 3 weeks, just to listen and to discuss and consider what God might want your faith to be and like how He wants it to be stretched this year. The first step toward a stronger body isn't just a 2-hour spin class, it's simply walking to the gym. So the next thing is to follow Jesus. If you've never made a commitment to follow Jesus before, today is a really awesome day to start. Talk to your small group leader, or I would love to talk to you as well if this is something that you're interested in doing. Or maybe you've made a commitment to Jesus once before, but recently your excitement has kind of faded and you're having a tough time keeping your commitment going. If that's you, today's the day to get back in the game. No matter how many times we forget what our commitments to Jesus are, He never forgets His commitment to us, and He is always waiting for us to come back. The third thing is to love God. Maybe you already love God and you're pretty secure in your commitment to following Jesus, but you just want to grow in your relationship to God. Maybe you want to spend more time with God, or you're just tired of struggling with the same thing over and over again. We're going to talk more about these things in the next couple weeks, but today you can commit to growing in your love for God. The fourth thing is to love others. Maybe you have a solid relationship with God, you're loving Him every day, and that doesn't really feel like the problem, but you could really learn how to love other people better. After all, Jesus says in a lot of different ways that part of loving God is loving others too. Maybe the best way for you to stretch your faith right now is to ask God for the help you need to love others better. And then finally, just ask questions. Maybe you're not ready to make any of these commitments right now, and that's completely okay. If you have questions, or if you have doubts, or you just want to know more about why so many people in this world, in our church, our youth group, or whatever, have decided to follow Jesus, this is a safe place to ask those questions. You might not find every answer right away, but there might be something new for you to discover. So on your card, mark down which of these things you want to focus on this month. And then write down one way you can start doing that thing. If you want to commit to showing up, maybe yours is simply saying, I'm going to be here the next 3 weeks. Or if you're committing to asking questions, write down one of those questions so you remember to ask it. And then if you're comfortable sharing, share with your small group or a close group of friends. Goals are a lot easier to achieve if you have a squad beside you, encouraging for you and praying for you along the way. So whether you've never made a commitment to Jesus before, or you've made a lot of commitments and never followed through, every day, including today, is a new opportunity to start. If you want your faith to grow and to be strengthened, it doesn't happen overnight. It does have to start somewhere, and it can start today with a simple stretch, because you can stretch your faith with a commitment.